performing so beautifully here tonight. I'm just saying, when I see a head being snapped in three different directions within a 30-second period, I'm thinking,
Brian, wait a minute. We saw that with Perella.
It was not a beating like this, Joe.
What he was doing to Ramos?
He wasn't battering Ramos to that level. Lennox, what do you think?
I think Caleb's going for it right now.
Lennox is ready to move on.
Get that 100% now.
Caleb is feeling good. He's throwing some great punches, and he's throwing some great combinations. And he's feeling the win.
Klagenfurt's able to throw an uppercut there and try to answer back, but he eats another body shot. His corner, Klagenfurt's corner, just telling our own Heidi Antrol that his nose is not broken. So, all right, he's bloodied up. We'll see what Klagenfurt has to say about that after, and what they'll say at the hospital, because his face is getting busted up.
Again, when Klagenfurt is actually covering up, he's missing some of the punches. He's like, he can't see some of Caleb's punches.
That was a dangerous right hand. You're right, Joe. That was a short right hand right off the shoulder. There's a good right hand by Plant, but Klagenfurt's still reasonably dangerous. I understand. I'm not saying, hey, let's stop the fight. A guy's getting hurt. Right. I know that. It's a world championship fight, so you might let it go a little longer. But I'm wondering, when it hasn't won a round, you have to start thinking about it.
Oh, Caleb is looking sweet right now with these combinations. He's doing the right thing. He's bringing him to the body and to the head.
And Klagenfurt is getting worn down again in his one loss. He was able to stay on his feet but got stopped.
Yeah.
Again. Let me tell you, Caleb can do what he wants in there right now. He's so far ahead.
Did you see him make that fake and Klagenfurt went for it? It was just, you could do that to a guy. And make him fall for just a simple fake. You know you got him.
That was a tremendous performance. Beautiful uppercut by Plant. Again, he comes off an easy win over Mike Lee, where he dropped him three times in the third round. Is he talking to you, Joe?
Yeah.
Say, mixing it up?
Yeah.
What did you get a call for? What combination?
Well, I think he's doing kind of what we talked about earlier, that, once he gets close to him, he'll just outgun him. He'll outmaneuver him just like that.
Three-punch combination. And then another three back-to-back combinations.
If Caleb steps it up, he could stop this man.
Yeah, well, Lee is looking closely. Right hand there by Klagenfurt, answering back. Still a lot of time left in this 10th round. So Lee goes to work again.
This is where you can really hurt
him. And Molly Kelly says, that's it. That's enough. And
I agree. Like I said,
a virtuoso performance in his hometown. The champion of the world at 168 pounds. In Nashville, Tennessee, they get to see their hometown kid come back and be victorious. Extremely impressive work by Caleb Plant.
Very impressive, very impressive. I mean, unbelievable. He did a great job in there. He looked terrific, fast, sweet, good on his feet, great defense. Hey.
What you saw him do, really, he did everything and anything exceptionally well. Inside, outside, boxing, defense, counter-punching. He's brilliant. He really is.
Respect there for Plant. Yeah. With Klagenfurt's corner. Again, outstanding job there by Plant. Again, they had said Klagenfurt's camp that there was a lack of respect, the trash talk they're not used to. I don't know what they're reacting to. Plant isn't really that type of guy. Maybe there is something else, but nothing but respect here. And respect to Klagenfurt as well, who did the best he could and was extremely rugged and eventually needed to be saved from himself.
Yeah.
Now, and the referee, you got to give it to Malik Walid. He stepped in at the exact right moment.
I agree.
Let me tell you, he's never seen a boxer like Plant.
Right.
So this is the first time that he got real surprised and schooled in this particular fight.
I'll tell you, Plant has got a really incredible figure ahead of him. You just saw him just really do it all from the close quarters to the distance game. He just looked masterful.
He's peaking. I mean, he's 27 years old. Mentioned earlier, he seems to be getting better and better with each fight. He wants to improve.